So, welcome to today's session number 17 of Ergonomics for Beginners, Industrial Design Perspective. Today, the module is fourth module, Posture and Movement, and today's session is a class number 17, it is the Posture and Body Supportive Devices. Now, just to have a gist of our last classes, where we mentioned that the awkward adopted posture and inefficient work output has a parallel relationship. People have different capabilities and job and task demand also varies. Towards making compatible interface between these aspects, attempts are being made, and ergonomics looks into the aspect of fitting the task to the human. In continuation to that the last classes, where we mentioned that working posture has three arms in the working posture triangle, that is that task requirements as per various tasks we need to adopt some postures, and then workspace design, equipment or work item, their dimension and their layout in a specific space, that is the workspace design, and some personal factors. Now, while discussing that, we mentioned that few aspects like avoid bending forward and backward. A twisted trunk strains the back, sudden movements and forces produce peak stresses. It must be avoided. Alternate postures as well as movements as much as possible should consider. Limit the duration of any continuous muscular efforts so that we can work with comfort and less fatigue. So, with this, today's topic in this class number 17 is that posture and body supportive devices. Now, the difference between human body and other animals are that we can adopt versatile body positions, postures, and we can bend any direction, and to stand erect and sit, it appears or it seems to be easier for us than an animal if he or if the animals can or wishes to stand erect, that would be an additional effort for them, but for human body it is the natural due to evolution. Now, but still the standing for a longer time or in a sitting like squatting and etcetera, where muscular efforts are required, there we need some kind of support to maintain that body posture. Now, today we are going to raise some points on this type of body supportive requirements and what could be its design approach from ergonomics point of view. Now, this session concentrates on issues relevant to. Now, here 13 topics we are going to discuss today. The first topic being the people variations, task and need context variations, people whom we are concerned and their limitations and facilities, skeletal system relevance for our posture, common posture adoption problems, sitting in confining means to do certain task, if we have to adopt a posture that is not good, but we adopt. Formal to informal transition of our working, sitting and etcetera, like office work. You see, what is the, now earlier office work, there is a formal atmosphere, but how the workstation design can be done in such a way that it should feel informal. In a formal context, the creativity does not open up. In the informal context, if you are free to decide yourself, and that also has some postural constraints or something like that, if you are free from those, then creativity can come. So, what? So, in this context, we will discuss something about formal to informal transition, specific reference to office type of work. Then task related postural adaptation require context specific, either a part of body or whole body support. Next, the challenging body ability and support. Exclusive and inclusive design approach, support overhead holding like accessories design. Now, we will be discussing after these two case studies, where some design development trials have been taken, like case study one, that school seat desk design concept, and the last is the case study number 2, a high seat with hip rest concept. So, these are today's topic matter. Now, if you see this left side figure, it is a very well known figure in a normally available in published form in a book, that a person is adjusting all the work equipment including the seating dimension, height and etcetera all to suit the workstation to this boy. Now, from here, if we analyze this figure, it can come that people have different muscle strengths and cognitive abilities, which is dependent on age, body build, gender, health, individual training and other context specific relevant factors. Now, always we talk about work, but the spending leisure also imposes postural risk. Like this left side figure, it explains this, explains that behavior matters. So, what type of body support requires here? The body support is not only to give a physical support to your body to maintain a body position, but it also should match with the requirement for the task. Body size itself links with postural risk. Now, in this case, in the figure, it says that the body figure shown here, as the body becomes fatty, like endomorphic body type, the coordination among body parts reduces. So, the way a normal mesomorphic person will use this chair, or while sitting, the pressure on the chair falls, this endomorphic type body figure, when it uses the this seat, it differs. Means the pressure point differs due to sway of body and etcetera. So, it requires proper support system. Somatotype plays a role in maintaining posture, and accordingly the support system should be developed. Now, some allowances also necessary to add or to consider while developing a body support system like seats. Here it can be said that the right hand and left hand and right hand, two figures are shown here. So, this says that it is okay, and why it says that it is not good? Because the swing or strength of a seat, which considers users of average weight or below, does not allow persons of heavier weights to sit. In the left figure, the seat is strong enough to carry average or low weight persons, but the right hand side figure, the same chair is not suitable for heavy persons with or without extra loads, it might break. So, while developing a body supportive device, we must consider its other allowance requirement. Now, body supportive device, when it comes to our mind, we consider bed comes to our mind. But bed, the common bed, is also act as a multi-use requirement, not only for sleeping at a rest, but while sleeping some activities are done. So, that support has to be given, and not only it is used for sleeping, but some other activities also that needs to be considered. Now, people whom we are concerned, the mesomorph and ectomorph and endomorph, that we have discussed in earlier sessions, but now the relevances. The physical appearances of extreme body types are different. Now, people like to see themselves well built and fit with maximum range of motion in joints, and this user image association with a design development program bears the same mindset. Whereas, we all greatly differ from that image of so called standard body. There are variations of body sizes that do not always conform to prefer symmetry and proportions among body parts. With that we can say that if we see this figure that the persons are typical office workstations are shown here. Your perception of a good job may not necessarily tally with that of someone else. Means everybody's task requirement is different and accordingly their furniture support is also different, the requirements is different. Now, sometimes to overcome those unwanted features, we overdo clothing and use varieties of decorations which in turn affect in negative way. In some cases it is said that if a chair or a seat like a car does not fit you, then some people suggest that put some cloth, a packet of packed cloth in the back of your seat. So, means seat backrest and your back just keep there so that you can adjust your body. Now, that may be a concern, but why we require that? Why that design cannot support the each and every user, and what would be the considerations for that, that we need to think. Our design activity must consider various body types and limitations thereby. Our design activities are to aid all the users rather than making a design and then asking them to fit in. Now, it comes our body and for the posture relevance our backbone. In this backbone, a multi-curved appearance of vertebral column plays a great role in maintaining posture. Now, see this bony structure has a S type, double S type of curvature. Why it is like that? Why it is not a straight vertebral column? There are many thoughts behind it, but mostly we can say that in this skull there is a small groove, it is called occipital groove at the back of the head, where the vertebral columns first bone atlas bone meets here with a pivot joint, and then all other bones joins together to form a vertebral column. Now, as it is placed this end part, one part, so the head comes forward, and so to maintain that balance, probably this is the cause of this bend, and this thoracic bend is to have the rib cage and to counterbalance it, the next portion has gone back and then the buttock and etcetera is there. But why it has taken this shape instead going for analyzing that, it would be good to see how best we can maintain this natural position. Like when we sit mostly it is said that we require a backrest at this lumbar region maximum, and when this body bends further, then we require another backrest extended till shoulder or head like that, that we will discuss in next sessions. But here it can be said that if we see the skeletal system, these are the specific points. The bone distribution in a skeleton and vertebral column with its multicurved S appearance, it requires to maintain even while sleeping also, this should be. Now, another thing is that if we use too much soft bed, then with a natural body pressure, normal body pressure, where the more pressure is there, that portion will go down, and where the less pressure is there, it will be up. So, the natural position of vertebral column disturbs, and ultimately it does not give a good comfort. While sitting also, if the seat surface is too soft, then the buttock bony portions, it does not get a proper support, and so with that very softness, the equal distribution of body load does not form, so it gives a tiring effect. Now, the common problems faced by furniture. Now, in a newspaper article, it says that in different cities, in like this way, it is said that in some cities here 51% of population, those who they asked inquired, they felt back pain, somewhere 56%, somewhere 54%, like that way. In different cities, different type of responses they got. So, means it says that back pain is a problem nowadays coming up, and people say that this backache probably due to bad posture adaptation, jerks, and lack of proper body supportive devices. Now, here in the right hand corner, some figures have been shown that if the chair does not match properly, then what are the problems may come. These are the problems may come if the furniture dimension does not match. Now, the social aspects of sitting, it also acts positively or negatively, or it affects on posture. Like interactive sitting arrangements, if we sit back to back, we do not want to see it as each other like that, it is called socio-fugal sitting arrangement. In certain cases where this type of atmosphere needs to be maintained, but the facilities are not like that, then people take some different type of postures to keep away from that another person's, maybe due to privacy or whatever the reason is there. So, due to this different postural adaptation, some problem might be there. And when this front to front meeting is necessary, it is that this sitting arrangement is called socio-fetal arrangement sitting. Now, what is necessary for the specific purpose, and accordingly this furniture placement and body supportive devices may be designed. Now, another thing is that formal and informal group arrangements, here these boys are also using some kind of furniture sitting support, and they also use some kind of support, but the case is in the formal case what happened in this case, these students they cannot move of the room. This is confined space here sitting. So, it will be more tiring than this one. Why it is not that much tiring relation to this one sitting? Because if the individual seats, they can modify, they can change, and they can even they can shift their positions also. So, the more freedom is there. Now, in a body supportive device, when we are using, whether it confines the posture or it gives a freedom to change, it is necessary to consider, and accordingly the furniture support system should be developed. With armrest, backrest, etcetera, it confines. Here it is a mixed type of atmosphere. Another thing is that if you are not allowed to change your posture as you wish, it gives a problem. Like when we are sitting or standing in a specific posture, a group of muscle is responsible to maintain that posture. But after certain period, it will get fatigued, and then the total body load should be taken over by next group of muscles. And while taking that change, taking over this body load, there is sway is there, and sometimes we require to change the posture to relieve those things. That facility, whether is provided, needs to be considered. In this case, in this figure, we said that some presentation is going on where a group of faculty members are judging those presentations. Now, here, though they are sitting in a specific posture, but they are free to move, so the less tiring. But where the if some other form of sitting, where the members are not allowed to move, it is tiring, and accordingly the body supported devices has to be designed. This is an office. Now, see the how the furniture arrangement and the workstation gives a postural strain. Now, the body supportive device is this one chair, is a good chair, it seems from me, this figure. But the computer monitor is placed in this corner, so that this space is available here to keep the monitor. But here is this is the a tray where the keyboard is kept. Now, to operate this keyboard and mouse here, and she has to look it from here and the sitting here. So, there are various body angles and postural changes are there. So, obviously, here his productivity as well as the body strain both are getting affected. So, then either modify the good workstation design, or if it has to be, then if we allow him to use a swiveling type of chair here, so that at least he can move without much resistance, so that can be considered. Now, finally, we can say that the formal atmosphere, semi-informal atmosphere, and then the informal atmosphere. The same furniture, if we use for the three different purposes, it does not suit. Like to make it informal, so this furniture and this furniture, same furniture, cannot give that scope. So, depending on the specific requirement of formal, semi informal, informal body supportive devices and furniture should be designed accordingly. Now, a concept of ergo-optics is coming nowadays, people say that many tasks one should do at a time. In addition to that, the thinking, that creative ability has to be cultivated. So, for that, a concept towards conceptualizing and inviting comfortable and productive working space, which confirms that most of the relevant ergonomics factors have been taken care of. Now, I am showing some of the examples. Like in this, the workstation concept is totally changed, the chair table concept. For this, this is a, you know, this person, for him this is the personal work area, whereas for meeting this is a separate table. So, the work and meeting, it is being separated out. For a meeting, if it is this table is a rectangular, it gives a formal feeling. When a organic form, this means that non-squarish or straight line form is there, it gives more interactive and more pleasing kind of thing. So, here it is like this way, so that what's happened, more closeness and comfort is also there with the chair development. What type of chair, chair height, length, breadth, etcetera, can be adjustable, that is there. Now, for a personal sitting arrangement, it can be said that personal workspace, office general workspace, and this is that interaction with visitors is totally three different setup is combined together with specific identity. And then the person with swiveling wheel chair, he can attend the three as and whenever it is necessary. Now, formal to informal transition, that car inside also has become office. Now, the office space is also like that, that mount down to interact between persons working, the surface is developed like this way, so that more closeness is there. While in office resting either on a floor or the sofa, it should provide that facility, means we are thinking for open office system, means less constraints should be there, so that the person with his own feeling, he can adopt postures. These are the some of the cases, the concepts taken from various publication sources. These are the some of the new office workspace and new work style is shown here. It gives like this, in this figure we can say that now the furniture, the body supportive device and then work area is in such a way that work as well as rest are all are possible, and if it is possible, the furniture can become a formal furniture also. So, this type of thinking nowadays have started and people are developing variations in it, depending on task requirement and body supportive devices requirement also. Now, the challenge to make new workplace is the functional with freeness. This is the main matter is coming nowadays. So, from formal to semi formal and formal feeling at home always. These are the some of the specific cases can be summarily mentioned here. Now, we will be shifting towards another type of body support, that is a challenging body ability and support. Now, the left hand corner, the crutch is necessary, it is shown here. The aged person and etcetera, they require stick to walk. Consider the practical application of effectiveness. One, now here I will show that, see that, I will tell always over design is not good. Here one design was developed, now we may see that whether it gives a good response or not, that a person, old person or a person with a movement disability, he requires a stick. Now, the designer has developed a special thing that instead of a straight stick, he made a bow type of walking stick, where a armpit support and a hand support is given here. The idea he developed that while walking, the stick end, it would not come in contact with the front foot, so there will be always gap. So he does not need to keep the stick sideways so that it should not touch the foot, number one. Number two is that as it has a bow type of structure, so at every step it would give him a spring type of action feedback, so that it will be very pleasing to walk. Now, the question comes, why we require a walking stick? As we cannot stand properly, we require a structural support. Now, if that structural support itself moves, then this bow type structure is not suitable, it is not giving that support. So, this structure may not work, but in an amusement park or somewhere, this type of things may work well. Why? Because the person is not dependent on that walking stick as structural support, but here the when the person needs structural support, it would be better to give a support, not that spring. So, the question comes with enthusiastic many developments we think, but at the same time we also think whether those development possibilities are really good or it creates some other problems. Now, body support device accessories. Now, the wheelchair people, bound people, or maybe some persons who cannot walk properly, stand properly, like that type of problems, like that, suppose a temporary problem. Suppose if I have a problem in my leg, I do not like to go to a toilet or a bathroom where only wheelchair bound people go, because mentally I am not prepared to accept that, and my this illness, that a leg problem, I break my leg or I develop some sprain with a plaster and etcetera, I know that after few days it will be over. So, it will be very difficult for me to accept that I am disabled. So, what happens? I will feel to go or to use the same toilet facilities where I am doing, I am using when I am able bodied. So, in that case, yes, some special structure support if we develop here, then it would be easier to assist for that. So, take the wheelchair for temporary purpose or even the permanent also, then this will be used as accessories. So, this is the exclusive requirement is fitted within or on an inclusive requirement. So, this is the exclusive and inclusive design requirement, we can do it. Now, another example of inclusive design, the toilets, some people are habituated with this, some people are habituated with the WC matter. But in a certain area, if we do not know, suppose in guest house or somewhere, we do not know what type of people are going to come there. So, there both the systems, if we keep, another feeling is that if we use is WC, but with the Indian style means what happens? One can squat on it. So, it acts as Indian style, and when it is used as a chair kind of thing, then it can work as a Western WC. So, here the things are developed. So, this piece, if it is placed here, then it becomes normal WC, and if it opens up, then this becomes Indian style. So, this is the combination of both the requirements. If we use, then it may be inclusive design, and this is also body supportive device. Body supportive device does not confine in only the chair, seat, bed, that type of thing. To maintain a specific posture, to do or to meet a specific task, what type of support system one can develop, that is the body supportive device. Now, another example we can give it here, that accessories development also for body supportive purpose. In this case, it is shown that in this figure, that in a bus handle, the bus handle is tall. So, short height people, how they can use it? So, what happens? The support overhead holding accessory, like downward extended attachments from the overhead handle, fixed at a height of 50th percentile comfort upper arm reach height for the convenience of smaller size travelers in a bus. It may be a short height person, ladies, children or anybody. So, without disturbing, in somewhere these rods are also like this way. So, that, but here what, this is also possible. And without that, that having a handle down, it is also possible. So, either to modify the whole design or use an accessory for body support to maintain a specific posture. Now, the case study number 1. In this case study, it is shown that there are many figures have been shown that school children, how they behave and what are the postural problems are there. After this study was done that how to develop a specific school furniture for them. Now, a specific school furniture for 2% sitting was developed, and while developing each and every step, the real users were taken as a subject reference. Now, here during prototype making through trial was given, which results in a design that invites children to use it. Now, here the what clearance and etcetera use. Now, while making this design dimension etcetera, mainly their behavior was considered. With that, the final design developed like this. In this final design, the seat plate, backrest, 5 degree inward inclined top, table top, the gap, and this is that a fixed book holder, and this is a specific thing that 2 floating additional storage bin in the front may be used if it is necessary, easy to enter, come out and etcetera, and a special hook is given in the 2 sides is for that hanging of the bottles like that, water bottles and etcetera, it is given. And this is for that 6 to 8 years child for to be used by 1st to 3rd standard classrooms, and also 2 other dimension furniture was developed for other group of students, higher group of students. Now, the students are using like this. This simple design can be mass produced. This design goes in tune with the playful nature of children, and such look good and work good furniture would promote an atmosphere more conducive to the learning process. What specifically we have done here? That children behavior, their body dimension, how they put pressure on the furniture, what task they do, accordingly the design was developed. Now, the second case is that now people work like this way, also like this way. Now, this is a drawing classroom in an engineering institute. So, where they are supposed to work here, and also a small stool is provided to sit, but mostly it is seen that the boys and girls they stand and work. So, with that it was decided whether a hip rest type of sitting arrangement can be developed, but hip rest cannot be used for continuously longer time, it may be short period. So, now make occasional use of a pedestal stool in standing work, that is the hip rest kind of thing, like here. A concept of a hip rest design may be used in such a context where either long duration sitting or standing is not necessary. A product was developed like this way, where it is a 30 centimeter diameter plate, and with these rods are like this, and this joinery rods are in 3 different heights to accommodate 3 different body postures. A stool with 3 different height tying members, these tying members are used as structural strength as well as foot rests for sitting with full foot rest using the highest one. Now, it is shown here a high seat with hip rest concept. This design also supports a semi standing posture by using the middle and the lowest one. Means sitting as well as hip rest both can be done. So, a device was developed like this. So, this is a context specific requirement, a body supportive device. Now, there are varieties of furniture sitting arrangements are available. This is the natural things, the natural surroundings. People like this type of comfort like this. So, variations and value added sitting design a concern nowadays. Now, the next class we are going to discuss, the next session topic is seat. Approach to design ergonomics way. So, next class will be class number 18, the chair characteristics. So, till then goodbye, we will see you next day with the chair concepts and the concerns. Thank you.